The whole one ball thing. Ridiculous. Like I said, a lot of people also come up to me and I get applause for my show, which is so cool, right? And there's not too many jobs to get the applause. Thank you, Captain. Yeah, not too many jobs to get applause, right? You usually gotta be involved in like sports. I guess I could have, you know, done this thing. I could have been a magician, right? A magic match. But to me, magic was never that cool. To me, this is like every single magic trick I've ever seen. It's like this, it's like. Yep, that's my card. juggling, this is the energy that juggling can bring to a room. So I had to be a juggler. And we gotta get the house lights up in 1 second so I can check on my crowd. My late five, we have women like this woman right here, front row, yelling up on the audience, Mike juggle, six balls. Thank you! Alright, so, I went home, I practiced like every single day of my life, man. Every single day of my life on how to juggle six, but you people, it's just one more.
Kids stand
heads up. He found out after the show he's 18 years old and he's wasted. He's drunk, but we were in Mexico, so it's totally cool. All right, so anyway, the kid stands up. I know he's in trouble because he starts doing this. And out of nowhere, the kid just wheels the ball at me. He hits me in the chest, 90 mile an hour fastball. I'm like, dude, you gotta play long. Come on, son, tell. I give him back the ball. Before I can say, chill out, the kid stands up again and just wheels it as hard as he can. Hits me in the chest. I completely lost him. I'm like, that's it. You want to play? I whip it at him as hard as I can. The ball slips out of my hand. I hit a baby, line drive the baby in the face.
Oh, so you're getting sued from right to left.
Yeah. It's not like I hit two babies. All right? And to tell you the truth, sir, it was an ugly, ugly time. Hideously ugly. So it's funny, right? Life, it just all kind of works out at the end. Anyway. Okay, so we've all seen this bit done. We've all seen this done. A guy comes on stage and gives a sight, they pretend like he can't ride it. And I'm like, well, then why'd you bring it on a ship? I think it's not supposed to be funny. So tonight I want to show you people something dangerous, something exciting, and the only way to truly, truly cheat is to take it out of the hand of a professional and let Paul get out of this thing. So how many people here want to see Paul ride the ship? Yes. Yes. Put it right here. It's a joke, dude. It's a joke. All right, so, Paul's got more balls than I do. That was eight. All right. Hey, stop touching, Paul. Yes, all right. Stop. We can see that. You know what? Oh. It's not as good. But he's wasted, so he makes it. All right, that one foot in. Yeah. One foot in word? No, it is not. All right. So by the way, Crystal, look at you people, look around, right? You expect me to ride this thing?
Yeah.
And you can't walk down the hall in a straight line, none of you people, by the way. And every time I do this bit, I feel like the captain can somehow see through see me. He starts doing this. And this is so much easier at land, if you don't even get it. So much easier. Ah, number two in the pants right there. Nasty! Okay, Paul, I want you to hand me the three machetes. Don't throw them at me like the last guy, whatever you do, alright? So, three machetes, one at a time. We're gonna teach. One second. Now, don't throw them at me like the last guy. Alright, one second. Let's grab one second.
One second.
Gotta be safe,
Mom. What is he doing?
With the three machetes. Any trick off. Under the leg. Okay, I will try this. Here we go, under the leg. Paul, what's your leg? Yeah. He was ready. That's not an under the leg throw. I don't know what the hell that was. That was just kind of weird. All right. So here we go. All this talk from this little sticky trick. Under the leg. Machetes. Unicycle. It's called skills, baby.
Thank you.